See what happens, Elise. Thanks very much. I want to get the reaction from the chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, Republican Senator Bob Corker of Tennessee, is still with us. I know you've watched this debate unfold. Where do you stand on who's right? Would it be the New York Times report, or would you say the State Department, Marie Harf, the strategic affairs advisor? I guess that's her new title over there.
Well, let me start by saying there's no question that Iran cannot be trusted, and I think that's universally felt. I don't think there are people on either side of the aisle that believe that Iran can be trusted. So this is not a trust but verify type of arrangement. It should be solely verify, verify, verify. There's no question that their stockpile has increased. That's not debatable. And what I hope is going to happen, they do have to get down to 300 kilograms as part of the agreement. I guess the question is, Wolf, are they doing this to put themselves in a better negotiating position by growing this stockpile while the negotiations are underway? Or are they not going to live by it? We don't know, but I hope that there will be no sanctions alleviate it until they get down to that 300 kilogram stockpile. Now, the problem is when the person said, well, this is not an issue, this can be dealt with. Well, I would like to know how. I mean, they don't have a conversion facility to downblend or downgrade or to do what they need to do with the 5%. So are they going to ship it out of the country? Those are issues that need to be dealt with, and hopefully will be dealt with, and hopefully, again, we haven't seen the final agreement. It'll be in a very black and white, explicit way that they have to deal with this. But again, they do have to get down to 300 kilograms per the political agreement that was reached on April 2nd.
I know that you've suggested that there was some sort of administration document out there that has the outlines of an agreement with Iran and what would happen after year 10. This is supposed to be a 10-year deal. You say the administration is refusing to share that document. What's going on here?
So if you read the political agreement that was achieved on April the 2nd, there's reference to something called the Iranian Nuclear Development Program. It's not capitalized. But there is a document that explains what Iran is able to do per the agreement after the 10-year period. You also may remember that the president, probably his staff was not happy with him in doing this, but in an NPR interview shortly thereafter, talked about the fact really in year 13, they would be at almost zero breakout time. And so I'd like to understand what we've agreed to relative to their nuclear development capabilities after year 10. I've asked the State Department for the document. They haven't given it to me. I've asked the Energy Department for the document. They haven't given it to me. I've asked the White House for the document. They haven't given it to me. And the only thing I can imagine, because they have not shared it with me, and I know that it exists, is that they think that it would shed bad light on what they've agreed to, and I think it would cause people to have concerns, again, after year 10, what Iran is able to do relative to the number of centrifuges, relative to the other kinds of development activities. And I think, Wolf, most of us want to make sure that if we're going to enter into an agreement, it's an agreement that will keep Iran from developing a nuclear weapon over a long term. And I don't really understand, unless they're concerned about what this content is or how it might shed light on the deal that's happened, I don't understand why they will not share with us what this document says. Again, it's their view of what they've agreed to relative to the Iranian nuclear development program.
So very quickly, Mr. Chairman, if they don't share that document with you and your colleagues, even behind closed doors in a classified session, you won't be able to support any deal that emerges? Is that what I'm hearing?
No, I mean, I can't imagine they're not going to give it to us when they actually consummate this deal. But, you know, we're having all kinds of briefings right now, Wolf, to make ourselves as up to date as we can on where this is. Last night we met with three scientists, the leaders of our national laboratories around the country that are dealing with this issue, and the energy secretary, to walk through the technical aspects. There's so much of this that is classified that, though, is very technical. And so we want to make sure that senators that are going to be dealing with this on the committee spend this entire month going through and making sure we're educated and understanding what the important aspects are technically of this deal, but also politically. And again, I think this is a document that would be very helpful to us. I can't imagine if the administration is proud of their work and proud of this agreement, why they would not go ahead and share that with us now.
Senator Corker, thanks very much for joining us.
Thank
if you get that document, let us know. Coming up.